Hello to everyone. In this video, let us discuss what is law of mass action and rate law, rate equation, and after that, what is order and molecularity. Okay, now let us see what is law of mass action. So according to law of mass action, rate of a chemical reaction is directly proportional to the product of the active masses of reactants. This is in simple way. But if we want to define in another way, means what is that? That rate of a chemical reaction at any instant is directly proportional to the product of the active masses of the reactants raised to their powers at that instant, raised to the powers which are numerically equal to the number of reactant molecules in stoichiometric equation. So that means here, if we give a simple reaction, MA gives products. For this reaction, according to law of mass action, rate is directly proportional to the A to the power M. And for any other some reaction, MA plus NB gives products. For this reaction, according to law of mass action, rate proportional to which one? A to the power M into B to the power N. Now we can write rate equals to K into A to the power M into B to the power N. So this is known as rate equation or rate law. And what is that rate equation definition here? A mathematical equation which gives relation between rate of a reaction and active masses of the reactants is known as, what is that? Rate equation or rate law. And in this, that K is known as specific reaction rate, or we can call that as speed constant, velocity constant, or rate constant. So different names are there for K: velocity constant, rate constant, or specific reaction rate. Then what are the characteristics of K? Let us see here. That rate constant K depends on only three factors. What are the three? Nature of the reactants, second one temperature, and third one catalyst. Only on these three factors that rate constant K will depends. Okay, then what are the units of rate constant K? Let us see what are the units of rate constant. See here, mole to the power 1 minus n, liter to the power n minus 1, and second inverse, where n is known as, which one means here, order. N is known as order. What is order? Let us see within few minutes. Wait. Okay, now for example, if reactants are present in gaseous phase, now the units of K are atmosphere to the power 1 minus n and second inverse. Here also n is known as, which one? Order. So these are the units of which one? Rate constant or specific reaction rate. Okay, then this is regarding which one? Rate constant. After that, we have to go for which one? Order. And also which one here? Molecularity. Order and molecularity, we have to go for those two factors. First, let us see which one here? Order. So what is the order means? We can go for two definitions. The first one, sum of the powers of the concentration terms of reactants in rate equation is known as order. So for this reaction, overall order is how much means m plus n. And with respect to A, order is m. With respect to B, order is n. But overall order of the reaction is how much here? M plus n. Another definition also there. The number of reactant molecules which will affect the rate of a reaction. Which affect the rate of a reaction. That number of reactant molecules also called as which one order. So for example, in a cricket team, total 11 members are there. But 11, that means 11 players are there. But in that, all that batsmen or all the players may not score that one or two runs or century like that. Some of them may go for zero only. That means here, all that players may not affect the what is that result of the match. Only some of them may affect which one result of the match. So like that here, the number of reactant molecules which affect the rate of a reaction, that number is known as which one order. Okay, then come to molecularity. So before going to molecularity definition, let us know regarding complex reactions and simple reactions. So the reactions which will occur in a single step, those are called simple reactions. And the reactions which takes place in multiple steps, those are called complex reactions. And in that complex reaction, each and every single step considered as elementary step. And in that, all elementary steps may not occur with same rate. Some elementary steps might take place slowly, some might take place fastly. And the slow step among all of those is called rate determining step. In a chemical reaction or in a complex reaction, the slow step is considered as rate determining step because the overall rate depends on that slow step only. So like that here, now what is the molecularity definition? Let us see now. The number of reactant molecules participating in slow step, that is rate determining step, is known as molecularity. So now let us consider one example here. Decomposition of H2O2. What are the products we know? This is overall reaction. But this reaction takes place in two different steps. Let us see what are those steps. In first step, H2O2 dissociate to give H2O plus nascent oxygen. This is a slow step. In second step, the two nascent oxygen combine together to give which one? O2. This is a fast step. And as per our description, slow step is known as rate determining step. As only one H2O2 participated, only one molecule of H2O2 participated in rate determining step, it is said to be unimolecular reaction. That means molecularity of this reaction is how much means 1. So like that here, the number of molecules appearing in slow step is known as molecularity. But the number of molecules which affect the speed of the reaction known as which one order. So let us see the differences between molecularity and order. So what are the differences? So the number of molecules participating in slow step is which one? Molecularity. But the number of molecules which are affecting the rate of reaction, that is known as order. So first difference is nothing but that definition. Just now we completed that definition. Okay. And second one, what is the second difference here? So let us see that. Molecularity is which one here? Theoretical value. This is theoretical value, but order is experimental value. Order is experimental value. So if we want to get clear idea regarding this, in a classroom, let us consider the total strength 30. So that is known as molecularity. The number of students appearing in the classroom, we can say it as molecularity. But all the 30 members may not influence the result of the classroom. The number of students, the students who are concentrating or who are listening to the classes daily and to the lecture daily, those only affect the result of the classroom. So that means here that order of the classroom may not be 30, because all the students may or may not listen to the classes daily. So like that, here we have to consider that example, result of the classroom influenced by some of the 30 students, not all the 30 students. But the total number of that students, molecularity of the reaction is how much? Means 30. So 30 is theoretical. With observation, we can calculate that means what is the molecularity. But how many number of students really concentrating to the lecture means it is not theoretical value. We have to go for experiment. If we conduct an exam, by the result of that exam, we come to know out of 30, how many members concentrated on the class and how many members are not. That means order is experimental value. Okay, then come to the molecularity, another one. Molecularity may not have which one? Zero and fractional negative values. Fractional negative values are not present. Now come to the again to that example classroom. So without any student, we can't give any lecture in the classroom. So molecularity may not become zero. And of course, fractional and negative. Fractional means half of the part of the body is there in the classroom. Will we dare to teach them? Means it's not possible. So like that, molecularity is not having zero, fractional or negative values. But order might have which one here? Zero, fractional, and which one here? Negative values may be present. That means here, out of the 30, if no one listening to the classroom, means order is how much? Zero. And some of the students may listen to half of the lesson, remaining half they may get into the sleep. That means what is now here? Fractional. And in case of some students, by listening to the class, if they forgot all the previous knowledge also, means that might become negative value. So like that, order may have zero, fractional or negative values also. And then another one here, maximum molecularity is 3 and maximum order also 3. Of course, there is no difference in that. And another one here, come to the molecularity. It is the value related to which one here? Individual steps. That means molecularity is belongs to which one? Means individual steps of that which one here? A complex reaction. But here, order is not related to individual steps. This related to overall reaction, but molecularity related to individual steps. So these are the differences between which one here, molecularity, and another one, order. So these are the differences. Okay, then after that, Let us see here which one here. Rate law for different type of reactions. For example, for a simple reaction, Ma gives products. So what is rate law or rate equation? R is equals to K into A to the power M. So this is which one here? Rate law or rate equation for a simple reaction. And now let us go for which one here? Rate law for reversible reaction. So see here, rate law for reversible reactions. How we have to write that rate law? One example here, H2 plus I2 gives 2HI. For this, rate can be written as, which one? Forward reaction rate constant K1 and backward reaction rate constant, let us consider K2. Now, K1 into H2 concentration into I2 concentration minus K2 into HI power 2. That means rate of forward reaction minus rate of backward reaction. So like this, we have to write the rate law or rate equation for reversible reactions. And then rate law or rate equation for side reactions. So first let us see what are side reactions or competing reactions or parallel reactions. Anything is same. Side reactions or competing reactions or parallel reactions. For example, if A is the reactant, it is giving B and also C simultaneously. And let it be the K1 and let it be the K2. This type of reactions are called side reactions. Okay, now one example I will give here. What is that? Actinium. Actinium will give which one here? Two products. What are that? Thorium 227. Of course, actinium mass also 227. And here, francium 223. This is mass number of francium. So simultaneously, actinium giving thorium and francium. So here, this is K1 and this is which one here? K2. So now, for this, how to write that rate law or rate equation? So now here, we can give which one? Okay. Okay, first let us see for this here. Rate equals to which one here? K1 plus K2 into A concentration. Rate equals to which one here? K1 plus K2 into A concentration. This is the rate expression for which one? Side reactions or parallel reactions, and we can call that competing reactions. For example, if K1 greater than K2, in that situation, A gives B will become main reaction, A gives C will become side reaction. When K1 greater than which one? K2, A gives B will become main reaction and A gives C will become side reaction. And for this, we can draw that which one here graph. Let it be the concentration and time. We can give that graph like this here. As the time increases, what happens? A concentration decreases, but here B and C concentrations increases. So this is the representation of that competing reactions or side reactions and that which one? Parallel reactions. For this, we have to write the rate expression like this. Rate equals to K1 plus K2 into which one here? Concentration of A. And one more example for this. If you consider the phenol. Phenol when subjected to nitration with HNO3, we get two products. What are the two products we can get here? Ortho-nitrophenol. This is the main product. And another one, para-nitrophenol. This is which one? Side product. Not the main product, side product. So like this, for the side reactions, we have to write which one? Rate law or rate equation. Another type of reactions also there, consecutive reactions. So what are the consecutive reactions? Let us see here. Consecutive reactions means we can give a simple equation like this. A gives B, gives C, gives so on. The type of reactions are called consecutive reactions. That means it is defined as the reaction in which products are formed from the reactants in one or more than one intermediate steps. That reaction is called which one? Consecutive reactions. That means that overall reaction is which one having so many consecutive steps. So such type of reactions are called consecutive reactions. And one example for consecutive reaction here, decomposition of which one? Ethylene oxide. It is said to be epoxide. So CH2 taken twice O. On decomposition we can get which one here? CH3OH. That, okay, we can get this one. And okay, sorry, what we can get here means HCHO. 1 minute, we can write here CH3CHO, acetaldehyde. What we can get now on decomposition? Acetaldehyde. Let it be the K1. And again this will produce which one here? CH4 plus CO. So these two steps, that reaction taking place. So the final products are formed through the, which one here? One more intermediate step. So that type of reactions are said to be consecutive reactions. And for this type of reactions, how we have to give the rate expression? For example, A gives B gives C, let it be the K1 and K2. For this reaction, rate of formation of B or rate of formation of B dB by dt can be written as, how we can write this? K1 into A minus K2 into B. So why we have written like this means very simple. For example, this K1 is giving which one? Rate of formation of B. And K2 giving that rate of disappearance of C. If we want to get net rate of formation of B, what we have to do here? The first step minus second step. That means, for example, I got 10 rupees from X person and I have given 6 rupees to Y person. Now, how much money with myself means 4 rupees? 10 minus 6. So, like that here, B got some 10 rupees from A and given 6 rupees to C. Now, what is the net amount remaining at the B means? This 10 rupees minus 6 rupees means 4. Like that here, K1 into A minus K2 into B. Like that we get which one means here, rate of that formation of which one means B here. In which type of reactions? In consecutive type of reactions. Okay, in our next video, let us go for what are the zero order, first order, second order reactions, fractional order reactions, etc. Okay, bye.